Hey, reruns of The Dukes of Hazzard have been pulled from screens across America. The classic 1970s show was removed from TV schedules because of its Confederate flag imagery. The flag has a historic connection to slavery and the Civil War. The governor of South Carolina called for the flag's removal from the state's capital just last month. I'll throw this one to you, Tim. The show was created in a different era with different values and different morals. Do you think they should be pulled, these TV episodes?
If we took every anachronism off television, there'd be nothing on television. Yeah. Even cookie shows would have to go. So, yeah, the Confederate flag has a very, in some parts, ugly history, but there isn't a flag on earth that doesn't have some ugly event associated with it. We have a similar problem with the Southern Cross flag, which has been used by extreme right-wing dingbats to march with. Mm. It's the kind of thing where really it's better just to say, well, look, this was the 70s, what did they know? And it's what it is. There's no point in banning things.
It's just I'm sick of the constant kind of knee-jerk response to everything that, you know, well, if there's any doubt about anything, we ban it. And I'm actually writing about this week. Like, this knee-jerk response that anything that is slightly problematic, well, we just ban it. This is what the Nazis did when they started burning books. You know, it's insane. Now, clearly, the Confederate flag has... And this was all done, of course, in the wake of the Charleston massacre,
yeah,
which is absolutely
awful.
Yeah,
a knee-jerk reaction to that.
And you can understand, I suppose, why they just want to avoid any blowback. The real problem is that every bloody man and his dog in the United States America is going around with a bloody gun and killing people. That is the problem. They have a murder rate that is tens of times higher than comparable countries in the rest of the world. If you want to actually address why people are going around killing each other, stop them having guns. It's not the bloody Dukes of Hazzard. It's because everyone is packing.
Yeah, well... yeah. I think you make a very good point. Comedies as well, like Mind Your Language, Love Thy Neighbour and It Ain't Half Hot Mum, would be banned today if under this kind of, you know, ruling for their racist nature. So should we just accept them for the time period that they were made in? Maybe learn from it and maybe use it as a tool to teach
absolutely.
Our kids.
And
that's not cool.
And a lot of old TV shows were very sexist as well and attitudes have moved on, but it doesn't mean, you know, we can't still watch Leave It to Beaver or whatever.
It never hurts to look back to see how the way we were. I think the governor of California has just taken that show off for the wrong reason.
Yeah, I mean, the interesting thing is when you watch shows like Mind Your Language or Love Thy Neighbour or Kingswood Country or whatever, it actually looks and feels so awkward when you see it that it actually highlights how far we've come. So it's not actually... Far from making people racist or condoning racism, it shows how absurd racism is. And that's a very different thing from, for example, having the Confederate flag on the South Carolina Parliament. Of course, that should not be there. That the Civil War was won and lost many, many years ago, and it shouldn't be an official symbol of a state. But to say that then you should airbrush it completely from history, or that you should go back and completely whitewash anything that is now deemed offensive, is completely the wrong thing to do. Even if you're the most vehement anti-racist or anti-sexist or progressive person in the world, if you actually eliminate all that from history and pretend it didn't happen, then there is actually no way you can learn from it and appreciate why it's stupid and wrong.
Yeah. If you want people to fight for something, ban it.
Yeah, exactly.
That's often what happens, isn't it?